Hello everyone, welcome to the last session of flower arrangement. In this session, we are going to understand about various guidelines which are required for the flower arrangement. In the previous session, we have studied about various designs and styles of flower arrangement which are possible or which can be made. After the session, a student will be able to understand the basic guidelines for preparing and conditioning of an aesthetic floral arrangement. Or you can say that you'll be able to take care of a flower arrangement to increase the shelf life. Zonal guidelines, if we talk about, these are some of the points in combination of the 8 zonal features and principles which needs to be kept in mind to ensure a good output product. Those 8 principles, with these some basic guidelines, ensures that the final product of flower arrangement which has been created is in harmony and balance with the interior and the color scheme of that particular location. If you remember, we have already discussed and talked about that for a flower arrangement, it is of utmost priority that you choose the plant material, flowers, your foliage, container, in balance or in combination with the background for which it has to be kept. Before making any of the flower arrangement, be very specific and sure and clear about the design plus the area or the location for which you want to keep it. Always choose the flowers, your leaves, fillers and the container so that it expresses the mood of that particular location or the occasion. It should not be that it is in contrary or it is not complementing the interior or ambience of that particular area. It should complement equally with the equal balance. If you want to create certain patterns in your flower arrangement, always choose to keep flowers with different stems or with different size. Always keep or insert your tallest stem very first so that it indicates the height of your flower arrangement which is required. The rest of the plant material can be inserted or placed accordingly. The very basic rule of flower arrangement is never mix a fresh flower arrangement with the artificial flower arrangement. If you want to make an artificial flower arrangement, go with the artificial plant material. And if you want to make a fresh flower arrangement, always choose all the plant material as fresh. Always be very specific while choosing the container plus while choosing the location, the placement of the flower arrangement. For example, if you want to keep or you want to make a flower arrangement which needs to be kept in the center of the lobby, you have to go for a design which is visible from all the 360 degree angle. So all the customer who are looking at the flower arrangement from different angles should have the equal eye appeal or the equal eye pull. For example, if we choose a circular or a pyramid shaped flower arrangement, that will be the best option for this particular area. But similarly, at this point, you cannot choose a triangular flower arrangement, as a triangular flower arrangement is best suited for those areas where it has to be kept against a wall or any of the background, because the triangular shaped flower arrangement will have a front view only. Most of the flowers which is made or the flower arrangement which is made, it has to be placed at the equal eye level so that the customer gives the permission to the customer to look at each individual plant material and to praise the beauty. All the plant material, if you want to make a cut on that, on the stick, on the stem, always make a slant cut or cut it slantly. This makes to insert the stem or the plant material in the oasis very easily. And it also helps the oasis to support that plant material with a going flow. Always make sure that the plant, flowers, leaves that you are going to make a flower arrangement with, always keep it submerged in the water in a container so that it gets the sufficient moisture and doesn't get dried or spoiled. Basic rule, or you can say the second important point in this, always restrict the placement of your flower arrangement near to any fruit. For example, say apples, pears or plums. The reason being, these fruits emit ethylene gas, which is not good for the flowers as it will cause wilting of your plant material and will obviously decrease and shorten the life cycle or the lifespan of the particular flower arrangement. So be very specific. If you want to create a good eye look, eye appeal, do not go for too many colors or do not make it messy with a numerous number of colors chosen for the plant material. You can restrict yourself to 2 to 3 or max to 4 of the colors and the flower, different color flower shape that you are choosing. If you want to create a focal point, you want to go for a focal point and emphasis in the flower arrangement, always do it very carefully so that all the attention of the customer can be drawn to the focus point or the focal point which has been created. This is again experimental, but yes, it is possible. Next is, if you want to make a flower arrangement with less number of flowers and more of foliages, this can also be chosen and experimented as it has been done earlier before also. Thank you so much. That was all from my side. Let's have a quick recap of the previous sessions that we have done. In the flower series, we have discussed about various flower arrangements in the hotels. We have discussed different flowers, different foliages, different containers which are possible or which are generally used in the flower arrangement to be kept in hotels. After that, we have discussed various equipments, tools, materials which is required for making or which is mandatory for the flower arrangements. Then we have also discussed some basic 8 principles, guidelines, or you can say 8 features of design which is mandatory to apply on the flower arrangement so that at the end you are sure that you have got a product which is complementing each other, each plant material is in equal harmony and is equally balanced. In this series, we have also studied and learned about various different designs in the flower arrangement. For example, we have seen circular, triangular shape, crescent shape, or various pyramid shape, Hogarth's curve, some of the abstract designs also we have studied in this series. Apart from this, it depends on the creativity of the arranger. It opens a gate for your potential to come up with more new designs. After this, in this session, we have discussed some of the basic guidelines, basic points, which needs to be kept in mind while you are making a flower arrangement so that after that, you increase or the life of your flower arrangement can be increased. As flowers are very soft, this needs to be handled very carefully and very gently. Thank you so much. I hope that these sessions of flower arrangement will be helpful for you and you have understood about each and every session carefully. I welcome the feedback of all the viewers in the comment box. If you want any queries to be addressed, please be in touch. Thank you so much. Have a good day.